Our today's topic is unconfined compressive strain test of clay soil. The unconfined compression test is a special type of UU test that is commonly used for clay specimen. Unlike the UU test, in this test the confining pressure sigma 3 is 0. An axial load is rapidly applied to the specimen to cause failure. At failure, the total minor principal stress is 0 and the major principal stress is sigma 1. The major principal stress sigma 1 will be equal to the maximum deviator stress. In this test, the maximum deviator stress or the unconfined compressive strength is taken as the maximum load attained per unit area or the load per unit area at 15% axial strain, whichever occurs first during the performance of the test. Theoretically, for similar saturated clay specimen, the unconfined compression test and the unconsolidated undrained triaxial test should yield the same values of undrained cohesion. But in practice, unconfined compression test on saturated clays yield slightly lower values of undrained cohesion than those obtained from UU test. So, for the case where the construction will be carried rapidly, in that cases, we can do the unconfined compression test. Here, no confinement will be applied, only you will apply the axial load. So, I can say that this test can be related to the determination of compressive strength of concrete sample which you have conducted in your materials lab. You will apply the axial load at certain strain. The commonly used strain rate is 1 to 2% per minute. And at one point, the soil sample will fail. You will record that load and calculated the unconfined compressive stress from that load dividing it by the corrected area. Generally, the specimen size for the unconfined compression test is the height of the sample will be twice the diameter of the sample. That means the height to diameter ratio of the sample will be 2. Generally, we collected the soil sample from Shelby tube, then trim it to have a straight ease, and then we will put it in the unconfined compressive test device. Then we will apply the axial load and record the load at different strain, and at certain point the soil sample will fail. Then we will draw the axial stress versus axial strain curve, and we will determine the maximum axial stress at which the soil sample will fail or the stress corresponding to 15% strain. Here, the peak stress and the stress corresponding to 15% strain coincide, but most of the cases it doesn't coincide. From the previous graph, we can see that the maximum stress is 72 kilopascal. As our confinement is 0, that means sigma 3 is 0, and our deviator stress is 72 kilopascal. So our sigma 1, the major principal stress, will be 72 kilopascal. So we have 2 points, sigma 3 equal to 0 and sigma 1 equal to 72 kilopascal. With these 2 points, you can draw the Mohr circle. And the undrained cohesion will be the half of the diameter of the Mohr circle. And according to the test data, you have to comment on the consistency of your clay soil sample according to this table. Suppose that you have got the unconfined compressive strength of your soil sample of 70 pound per square feet. So you can comment that your soil sample is soft. Here is two video link explaining the actual test procedure. You can watch these two video to have more clear idea about the actual test procedure. For the report, one Excel file has been uploaded. Here you have two problems. You have to solve two problems for your report. For problem one, you have the sample deformation and load data. So you have to calculate your strain, which is the deformation by the initial height of the soil sample. Initial height of the soil sample is given here. Please note the unit of the height of the sample and sample deformation. One is in millimeter and another was in centimeter. You have to convert it in one unit, either millimeter or centimeter. Then you will get your strain. You have to calculate it percent strain, which is 100 times in the strain. Then you have to calculate your corrected area. The diameter of your sample is given here, so you can calculate the initial area of the soil sample. Then you have to calculate the corrected area from the initial area by dividing the corrected area with 1 minus strain. You have already calculated the strain, so you can calculate the corrected area following the formula. Then you have to calculate the stress, which is load divided by corrected area. And again, note the unit of the stress. For problem 2, you have the deformation dial reading and load dial reading. Only the difference with the problem 1 is that you have to calculate your load and deformation from dial readings. Here the correlation has been given. That means that if you multiply the deformation dial reading with 0.1, then you will get your deformation in millimeter. And if you multiply your load dial reading with 0.3154, then you will get your load in pound. Then the rest of the calculation is same as problem 1. After doing all the calculation, you have to plot stress versus strain curve and find out the maximum stress, the peak stress, or the stress corresponding to 15% strain. Then you have to draw a Mohr circle. You have to use graph and drawing compass, not freehand, not using any software. Then you have to find out unconfined compression strength and cohesion of the soil. Then you have to comment on the consistency of the soil sample, whether it is soft or very soft or anything else. Then you have to compare the test 1 and test 2 result. That's all for unconfined compressive strength test. If you have any confusion, please let me know. Thank you for everyone.